we're just going in. See on the flip side, Pig Bay. Okay, so no absolute covers. So we've got Yoho versus Yoho. We've got some fun gameplay here. Let's see how this goes. Do we have anything? We really have Hindenburg, Venezia, Daring. Let's remove the music really quickly there. From what I could tell, we don't have really anything that surprises us from what we currently have. Let's check the free view. We do have a Smolensk with Man of War in it over here. As we can watch and see the entire setup, we do have a Vermont, we have Strider and a Moskva, and we've got a Yamato over here. So we definitely have a good balance. We have 2, 3, 2, and then on the opposite side, we once again only running that one Daring, which is kind of an interesting strat. We'll see if that pays off again. Last time it didn't. Over here, once again, we've got Epicenter, so we got a Venezia, which of course, when you only have one Daring, kind of loses its power over here. It doesn't lose power because actually it's on the ship. Okay, I cannot talk today. Let me restart that and such. But on the B side, we've got 2 battleships, 4 cruisers once again, but of more of a variety, less of Worcesters and a Venezia and a Hindenburg with a Daring. Let's pop this up. Obviously, this is Epicenter, so we are definitely looking at taking caps, putting themselves in positions to cover themselves. Especially with this map, you're going to have a lot of island play early on. So we will see exactly how they look. It looks like the Northern Yoho team will absolutely be holding themselves in the C cap, trying to maybe take the middle one. I'm not really sure here. We definitely have Sinestro launching off some Area of Denial torps, just trying to get them out there, trying to make the enemy team think and such. But we definitely, it looks like, I'm not gonna lie, looks like we have 2 turtle strats meeting each other. So this is all about who can land the better shots, who can focus fire better, and where that RNG ends up being, especially when you have a Vermont that it definitely can land some alpha, but can it survive getting targeted? Can it do everything like that? We definitely do have Man of War smoking up in the Smolensk, and we do have the middle cap absolutely taken. Once again, these Area of Denial torps are going to be pretty powerful in a turtle strategy because they're going to keep the enemy thinking, keep the enemy moving around, trying to really reevaluate, maybe also keeping the amount of guns that they have on target less. So we shall see. And sometimes you might get some damage like this Hindenburg. We're going to call it that from now on, I guess. But as you can tell right here, we just have a lot of island play, a lot of just sit here, try to hold the caps, especially from the first game. Caps are important, but with Epicenter, it's a very much a situational, how can you do that versus not. They do have the middle cap with the southern team versus the northern team having the top cap. So right now the middle cap is in contention. We do have Sinestro and Kriegsmarine going at it with a little bit of challenge there. Absolutely not wanting to actually make their move yet with the Daring on here, trying to keep that there, keep the push on there. Sinestro seems to be actually pushing right here. Does have backup from a Smolensk and a Minotaur with Sync, so that should be an interesting see how that looks when, especially, you've got so much firepower concentrated in one area right here. This is exactly where these Area of Denial torps can kind of play a role in winning the game eventually, but we will see if that actually pays off. So right here, of course, Neo making a break, kind of just sitting there, not actually having any challengers. So just absolutely sending off torps left and right. Over here, we got Sinestro and Kriegsmarine. Sinestro is doing a decent job, but not overall winning that fight. Definitely needs some more assistance over here. We do have Man of War in the Smolensk getting what looks to be focus fired right now. So we'll see how long that Smolensk lives over here. Once again, Neo is absolutely sending Area of Denial torps, trying to make people think, trying to get them away from firing their guns and get them focused on dodging rather than shooting. Right here, we do have a clat. Like, all the ships are in one single area. We do have a good spread down here of different types of ships, but what they really need to do is really pressure it and get one person out. You need to break the turtle by focus fire, not by doing anything else. Next thing you can do is buy a lot of torps. This is where a Somers instead of a Garen would absolutely be hilarious, because you could just literally flood the area with torps. But a Garen can do a pretty good job. We do have Kriegsmarine looking like he wants to poke the bear again with Sinestro over here. Definitely a slug match. If I don't say myself, the Vermont not firing right now behind an island. Problem with the Vermont is it's DPM, or it's DP, even it's damage per game sucks if you don't keep it firing. But that Hindi just took a massive hit, so we'll see if Odin goes down on there. But we definitely have the Venezia showing its strength of being able to kind of cover up people, cover up itself, keep a little bit more alive. Sinestro ends up taking out Kriegsmarine. Unfortunately, I missed that, but that was a very, very good play, probably with guns and using the sonar. So now the two DDs can start breaking this turtle. So you got a minute left. All you have to do now, and realistically what they exactly are doing right now, is hold the caps. Keep those steady. You don't necessarily need to kill them. Sometimes it's all about just staying alive. Man of War is definitely staying out there pretty far, along with Neo absolutely just sending out torps just up into that general cap area. As you can see, Sinestro is firing on some certain enemies, especially it's like Strostop, absolutely taking, trying to get set afire. So just trying to do that. But right now we do have cap control, 200 points extra. So in reality, they could just sit back and relax, just slug it out. Odin goes down, probably confirming the win right there. And it looks like the Venezia is trying to hunt down Sinestro, but we do have Man of War pushing on that. That's a very dangerous ship against those two styles of ships, but it doesn't have any support with it. And that's the problem with it. And you can see Sinestro absolutely employing, hey, send off some torps, but don't send off all 10 in a particular direction. And right there, Stormrunner gets taken down by Sinestro. Sinestro, great job on those right there. Absolutely doing it great. But you can see a turtle strat versus, I want to say, a wide turtle strat. I'm betting Pig Bay's got a better term for that than what I have. But of course, we are seeing the DDs having additional ones breaking up and eventually winning those games with doing that. And we do have a win from that. Nice job and nice plays. Very slow game, but that's what a turtle strat is. Pig Bay, let's hear your awesome recap on that, because of course that was just a turtle strat.
So that all came, it was two turtle strats, but one team brought two DDs where they were able to go in, hold the caps early, and then the other team had to fight to try to get those caps back. You know, you even saw the Yamato try to push in a little bit, but then some torps came and he was like, nah, I'm not doing that. So yeah, the two DD versus one DD is hard for that one guy to contest two other stealthy DDs. You know, that's just how it is. That's the nature of the beast. So if you're going to run that, I mean, your team has to kind of, you know, they're kind of forcing them to push in a little more. I just don't like it. Let's see. I'm looking at my notes. Sorry. Yeah. So that lone DD was also taken down by Daring Guns and also Focus Fire from the cruisers. I was watching that go down. So that's how he went down. And then I also like that I saw the Daring not bet the farm on those torps, because that is something we saw a lot with the Jervises in Ruler's Wave 8. Everybody just betting the farm on those single fire torps, but we didn't see that. We saw Aerial Denial, and I like that.
Yep.
But good match, good match.
Yeah, it definitely was a battle of attrition when you're playing Epicenter. A lot of times they turn into those turtle games, definitely a thing that's interesting.